tree may be a crowd, but it's also the beginnings of a kick-ass gang.
All right, already, I'm hip!
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 fictional gangs in movies.
This is big time, baby.
For this list, we're looking at groups of three or more characters that have formed or organized themselves into gangs that really only existed in the movies. In some cases, that's a bummer, and in others, that's a good thing because they're terrifying.
I can dig that.
Hey, you know, you came to the right guys.
We'd much prefer the gangs that would battle you with full extensions and pirouettes than the type that would shank you in front of your mom. Number 10, The Cobra's Gang, Stand By Me.
Let's play ball!
This Stephen King story tells the tale of four young boys who embark on a journey to find a dead body.
You guys want to go see a dead body?
Like most kids, obviously. But they never would have known about it if Vern hadn't overheard his older brother Billy talking about Ray Brower's missing corpse.
The train must have hit him.
Fucking deal.
Billy is part of the Cobra Gang, led by Ace Merrill, who also go on the hunt.
You're gonna have to kill me, Ace.
No problem.
With their violent and bullying ways, they're a stark contrast to Stand By Me's protagonists.
Why don't you tell me something I don't know, asshole?
And while neither group of boys has to stare down the face of a murderous clown like the Losers Club kids from It, finding a dead body is probably frightening enough on its own.
Let's look for some long branches. We'll build him a stretcher.
Number 9, The Go-Go Dancers, Faster Pussycat, Kill Kill.
I'm gonna love squeezing you out.
Who doesn't like a gang of no-nonsense go-go dancers that races cars in the desert? That sounds awesome, right?
You wanna prove something, chickies? Let's see who the real chicken is.
That is, until they're literally murdering you and assaulting your family. This 60s exploitation flick follows a trio of beautiful ladies who don't appear to shy away from crime. After challenging a man and his girlfriend to a race, they kill him and take his girl hostage.
Plant him stiff in his heap. He's had a bad accident.
They then end up at the home of a gross old man and his beefy but mentally impaired son.
Now why don't you drop that tree you're holding and let's grab a vine and swing a little, huh?
And since this girl gang isn't one to be messed with, they make a mess of things while trying to locate the old man's riches. Number 8, The Hershey Gang, Escape from L.A.
Oh, hey man, how you doing? Long time no see, remember me? Map to the Stars, Eddie. Yeah, well I got somebody I want Hershey to meet, Snake Plissken, baby, right here in the flesh.
In this follow-up to 1981's Escape from New York, Snake Plissken is back, and trying to escape from things in the newly formed island of Los Angeles, as well as attempting to retrieve a global weapon for the wacko president.
So what are you going to do?
He's got 10 hours to live, and after trying unsuccessfully to retrieve the weapon, Snake turns to his friend, Carjack Malone, for help.
You're Carjack Malone.
Not anymore.
Except Carjack is now Hershey Las Palmas, and she runs with a crew of deadly trans women who know a thing or two about survival.
You get one thing straight, Plissken, I'm no longer Carjack Malone. I'm Hershey Las Palmas, the most drop-dead to die for number you ever laid that one eye.
With the help of her crew, Plissken is able to take down the opposition and recover the weapon. All while looking fabulous, of course. Number 7, The Lost Boys, Hook.
Lost Boys! Lost Boys, wake up!
In this Steven Spielberg flick, Robin Williams plays a grown-up Peter Pan who has no recollection of his past in Neverland.
How far back can you remember, Peter?
Now he's a big-shot lawyer with a family, and it's not until he visits London and reunites with Wendy Darling that he's forced to confront his previous life.
Peter, don't you know who you are?
When his children are kidnapped by Captain Hook, his trusty Tinkerbell leads him back to his childhood friends, the Lost Boys.
That ain't Peter Pan. He's old.
He's fat.
Not so fat to me.
Now led by Rufio, this group of kids makes their own rules and lives life on their terms.
Kill the lion!
And they're surprisingly formidable in pirate battles.
Looky, looky, I got hooky.
Number 6, The Droogs, A Clockwork Orange.
That is Alex and my three droogs.
There's nothing like a gang of roving sociopaths to make you want to swear off humanity. In this 1971 classic, Malcolm McDowell plays Alex DeLarge, the leader of a group of petty teenage criminals.
As I am your droog and leader, I'm entitled to know what goes on, eh?
The droogs, as they are known, spend their time getting high, assaulting people, hooking up with girls, and wearing all white. In spite of all that, and the fact that they basically paralyzed a dude and sexually assaulted his wife, they seem to evade the police. At least most of them do.
It was only a slight old chalk. She was breathing, I swear it.
After Alex is arrested, he is forced to undergo mind control experiments, but at least will always have the memories of his eyeliner.
I've learned my lesson, sir. I see now what I've never seen before. I'm cured, praise God.
Number 5, The Greasers, The Outsiders.
God, you filthy greaser.
A gang comprised of Rob Lowe, Tom Cruise, Emilio Estevez, and Ralph Macchio seems like they might just act you to death. But these guys are tougher than they appear.
Ain't nobody gonna call the police in this neighborhood! Straight knife better! Hey.
In this drama, their characters are joined by C. Thomas Howell, Patrick Swayze, and Matt Dillon to form the Greasers, a bunch of bad boys from the wrong side of the tracks.
Seems like it's gotta be someplace without greasers and socias.
When one of them accidentally kills a kid from their rival gang,
I killed him.
Their conflicts transform from occasionally adversarial to all-out warfare. And while they may look like a band of hooligans at first blush, they save kids from burning churches too. So they're not all bad. Number 4, The Natives, Gangs of New York.
What's the battle? Natives against the dead rabbits.
Back before Manhattan was all yuppies and cosmopolitans, it was the site of some of America's grittiest historical events. This Martin Scorsese film follows the story of a young man who witnesses his father's murder at the hands of the leader of a rival gang, the Natives.
But his dead rabbits is done and outlawed!
The Natives oppose the influx of Irish immigrants, and they're led by the deadly Bill the Butcher Cutting.
Us Natives, born rightwise to this fine land!
Their frequent clashes with the Irish gang, the Dead Rabbits, come to a head at the onset of the racially charged draft riots.
On your order, Valen.
But in spite of the chaos around them, the Natives stay committed to their goal of fighting the Irish until their deaths. Number 3, The T-Birds, Greece.
Well, that's cool, baby.
This gang of teenagers is a far cry from some of the more rapacious and murderous crews on our list. Instead, these greasers prefer to slick their hair down, sing and dance numbers, and chase girls.
I did meet this one chick. She was sort of cool.
You know, mean she puts out.
Led by John Travolta's Danny Zuko, the T-Birds don matching leather jackets, similar hairstyles, and court the pink ladies, their companion Lady Click.
You guys, how do you like Sandy, huh? Do you think we can let her in the pink ladies?
While they spend most of their time singing and dancing, they also engage in high-stakes street races with their rival gang, the Scorpions.
Hey, look, man, those Scorpions, they're asking for it.
But at least no one ends up dead.
That's the way it should be. Wow, yeah!
Number 2, The Warriors.
Warriors, come out to play!
This 70s cult flick follows the story of a rough-and-tumble street gang named the Warriors, who are framed for the death of another powerful gang's leader.
The Warriors did it! The Warriors did it! The Warriors did it!
This means they have to make it through the streets of New York without getting killed by the multitudes of rival gangs, like the Riffs, the Baseball Furies, and the Punks, as well as avoid getting picked up by the cops. It's a harrowing night for the scrappy gang, but they emerge victorious and redeemed. Well, redeemed among the street gang community, at least.
You warriors are good. Real good.
Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions.
I want you all to become full members of the Foot.
Little Hen says it's time to rock and roll.
Hey, somebody tell me what that means, BRMC. What does it mean?
Black Rebels Motorcycle Club.
Number one, The Jets and the Sharks, West Side Story.
Okay, Sharks.
It's all pliés and grand jetés until someone gets hurt.
I say I want the Jets to be the number one.
This classic musical tells the story of two rival gangs, the Jets and the Sharks. But in the midst of their rivalry is a love story.
I love him.
Paralleling Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, the film follows Jets co-founder Tony and his love for Maria, the sister of one of the Sharks' leaders, Bernardo.
Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria.
Obviously, their gang affiliations make their romance a little difficult, and it's underscored by the ongoing dance battles and stabbings going on between the competing groups.
Let's go!
The rivalry comes to a violent head, with broken hearts, worn-out dance shoes, and a gunshot victim by West Side Story's end.
They won't let us be.
Then we'll get away.
Do you agree with our list?
You better believe it.
What's your favorite fictional movie gang? For more entertaining top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.
Prepare to receive the true Lord!
Yeah!